I am about to make a lot of people very angry because I'm about to debunk one of the most beloved myths about animals that the world has ever seen. One that has been reinforced time and time again in popular media like Congo and the more recent Planet of the Apes movies. I'm talking about apes who can communicate through sign language, specifically Koko the Gorilla, who reportedly mastered American Sign Language using over 1,000 signs. I'm KP, and I've worked as a staff biologist at accredited zoos and aquariums for over a decade. In the 1960s, researchers began attempts to teach great apes to use individual signs derived from American Sign Language. One of the original test subjects was a chimpanzee named Neam Chimpsky, a dunk on Noam Choamsky, a linguist and prominent critic of this field of study. Chimpsky was part of an extended study of animal language acquisition at Columbia University, led by Herbert S. Terrace. Terrace is an interesting figure in this story. Initially, he rose to academic fame and stardom for his apparent success with Neam. But to his credit, Terrace is a true scientist and actual skeptic. After he carefully reviewed the video evidence, he noticed that the researchers were prompting the apes and that the apes were essentially mimicking the human's behavior. Or as the scientific journal Big Think put it, the apes were aping it. Terrace noted that all Neam sentences were usually just two or three words that formed a general pattern. They usually started with the self-references, Neam or me, followed by a potential reward like eat, play, tickle, banana, grape, or whatever. Ultimately, Terrace concluded that Neam was unable to use words conversationally, let alone form sentences. Which leads me to Koko the Gorilla. Koko was born in San Francisco Zoo and lived most of her life at the Gorilla Foundation's preserve. Her instructor and caregiver reported that Koko had an active vocabulary of more than 1,000 words and understood more than 2,000 spoken words. There's even a video of Koko delivering a message about climate change, which is cool if it were real.
I'm sorry. It makes me cry. It's time to hurry. Fix the Earth.
Putting the message of this video aside, do we really think Koko understood man-made climate change? Combine that with the fact that this video is heavily edited and pieced together from who knows how many hours of footage and takes.
Nature sees you. Hurry. Protect the Earth.
Critical evaluations of the video evidence suggest that Koko was simply responding to cues from her trainers to display specific signs. These cues can be conscious or even unconscious in what is commonly called the clever Hans effect. Criticism from the scientific community also noted that while Koko often appeared in the popular press, there were very few scientific publications with any substantial data. Another concern was that the meaning of Koko's signs were always restructured or reinterpreted by her handler, which you can see in this transcript from a live interview Koko did with a group of high schoolers. I'm going to play the part of Koko's handler and let a text-to-voice bot read Koko's answers. Let me explain to Koko what we're doing. We're going to be on the phone with a lot of people who are going to ask us questions.
Nipple.
About you and about me, lots of people.
That red pink.
That red pink, yes, right.
Hurry good.
Our first question is, Koko, are you going to have a baby in the future?
Pink this.
We've had earlier discussion about colors today.
Koko love eat sip.
What about a baby? You going to have a baby?
Unattention.
She covered her face with her hands, which means it's not happening basically, or it hasn't happened yet. SBM87 asks, what are the names of your kittens and dogs?
Foot.
Foot isn't the name of your kitty.
Here lip.
Do you like to talk to people?
Fine, nipple.
Yes, that was her answer. Nipple rhymes with people, okay? She doesn't sign people per se, so she may be trying to do a sounds like, but she indicated it was fine. What? SickboyRE asks, Koko, have you taught other gorillas sign language on your own?
Myself lip.
She taught herself. That's really true, too. That's very good, and I think what part of that answer might be is that she's taught us. In other words, myself lip was her answer, and lip is her word for woman. So herself has taught lips, perhaps. So there are a couple of interpretations there. That one's gonna have heavy sarcasm, I can't help it. Koko, how do you feel about Michael?
Foot, foot, big toe, foot, good go.
Foot means male, right? Yes, Michael's a good male.
Nipple.
And then she signed nipple.
Browse for their hurry.
Oh, she said something for Michael, or what for?
Browse drink polite nipple, their hurry.
I posted a link to this transcript down in the description, so you can read it for yourself. Let me know in the comments what you think. Specifically, if you think it demonstrates that Koko had mastered American Sign Language, as headlines claim. Personally, I think it requires a willing suspension of disbelief to think that Koko understood the meaning behind her signs, or as the Chicago Tribune put it, we wanted to believe in Koko, and so we did. In my opinion, Koko responded to questions with gibberish, and the meaning of her signs was essentially made up by her handler in order to create the illusion of communication. Foot means male, brows means food, lip means woman, and nipple is Koko's word for people? Let's go back to the climate change video. Sherman Wilcox, professor of linguistics at the University of New Mexico, wrote this for NPR. This is obviously a doctored video composed of highly edited clips of single signs pieced together to make it look like Koko is actually saying something when she's not.
Man, I love man. Earth, I love the earth.
It is disconcerting on so many levels. I fear it diminishes the seriousness of climate change as an issue. Climate change deniers already feel like scientists are lying to the public. We don't need to give them fake videos. Also, I worry that it sends the wrong message about American Sign Language and Koko's abilities. It feels disrespectful of American Sign Language. Sign linguists have worked for more than 6 decades to show that signed languages have not only words but also syntax, the glue that enables us to use single words to express complex concepts. This video makes it seem as if ASL has only words and no syntax. So you can see how this well-intentioned video not only undercuts the climate change message, but it also hurts people who use ASL and rely on it to communicate. Ultimately, the study of ape sign language is dormant. There hasn't been a paper published on the topic in over 10 years. There is only one signing ape still alive, and he hasn't been trained in decades. I think that's the most damning piece of evidence. If Koko truly learned how to speak sign language, then why have researchers given up on this study? Why haven't they taught other apes to do the same? A linguist at the University of California at Santa Cruz put it this way: it would be wonderful if animals could say things about the world, but they just don't.